Welcome to the next session of annuities. In the last class, we solved some problems based on application of annuities. Now let me introduce the concept of annuity view. Annuity view. Let me introduce this concept, annuity view. Now look at this. When equal payments are made, when equal payments are made at the beginning of equal intervals of time, it is called an annuity due. Look at this. When equal payments are made at the beginning of equal intervals of time, it is called an annuity due. Let's see an example. This is beginning of first year. Beginning of second year, third year, fourth year, etc., 10th year. All these are beginning of 10th year. This is end of 10th year. Now a person deposited rupees 2000. A person deposited rupees 2000 at the beginning of each year. 10 payments are given. But the amount is withdrawn. At the end of 10th year. Here I am interested to know what is the cumulative value. Means how much it will amount to. How can you think this way? Now last payment is given on the first working day of 10th year. So this is in the bank for 1 year. Look at this point once again. Last payment is given at the beginning of 10th year. And amount is withdrawn at the end of the 10th year. So this particular 2000 rupees is in the bank for 1 year. Suppose rate of interest is I percentile day, 2000 into 1.06 to the power 1. I is equal to 0.06. Let us take 6% interest. Next, the payment proceeding to this is beginning of the 9th year. It is in the bank for 2 years. Beginning of the 9th year to beginning of the 10th year, it is 1 year. Beginning of the 10th year to end of the 10th year, so it is in the bank for 2 years. So the payment proceeding to this is in the bank for 3 years, etc. If I proceed, look at the first payment, how many years it is in the bank. Beginning of the first year to beginning of the second year, beginning of the second year to third, third to fourth, fourth to fifth, fifth to sixth, sixth to seventh, seventh to eighth, eighth to ninth, ninth to tenth. Up to beginning of the 10th year, it is 9 years. But the amount is withdrawn. At the end of 10th year. So last payment is in the bank for 10 years. This first payment is in the bank for 10 years. So you will get a 10 years interest. So if I find out them and adding, what will be the value of this? What will be the value of second, third? This way if I proceed, I'll get accumulated value. This way, doing each and every calculation is time consuming. I want a single formula with the help of which I can calculate the accumulated value in case of annuity due. Okay, have a look on this one, then I'll go to generalized result for this. Let's see. Generalized result, this is beginning of first year. Beginning of first year, ₹1 is deposited. Beginning of the second year, beginning of the third year, this is beginning of nth year. This is end of nth year. This is end of nth year. This one. Now, the last payment is given by you on the first working day of nth year. That is beginning of the nth year. It is in the bank for how many years, sir? 1 year. So, it is R into 1 plus I, because every one of we know in annuities interest is always compound interest. So ₹1 of mine will become R into 1 plus I at the end of 1 year. Proceeding to this, one more payment was given by you. It is in the bank for 2 years. 1 plus I whole power 3, etc. This way if I proceed. This first payment is in the bank for full-fledged N years. This first payment is in the bank for full-fledged N years. So this is R into 1 plus I whole power N. R into 1 plus I whole power N. Now, look at these payments. R into 1 plus I, amount is equal to plus R into 1 plus I whole square, R into 1 plus I whole cube, plus R into 1 plus I whole power N. This way, by adding all these values, you will get amount. If you see this sequence, it is in geometric progression. It is in geometric progression with the first term as R into 1 plus I. With the first term as R into 1 plus I, and the common ratio is 1 plus I. So amount is equal to, first term is R into 1 plus I. Look at this, what is the formula for sum in a geometric progression? This is the formula we have for sum to n terms in a GP. Here A is equal to first term, R is equal to common ratio, N is equal to number of terms. First term is A into 1 plus I. 1 plus I whole power N, common ratio is equal to 1 plus I. How can I get common ratio? Second term divided by first term is equal to third term divided by second term, etc. This way it is going on. So I will get 1 plus I as common ratio. Minus 1 divided by I plus 1. That is 1 plus I minus 1, R minus 1, plus 1 minus 1 cancel. So this is R into 1 plus I whole power N minus 1 divided by I. This is the formula we have for calculating the accumulated value. Now let me modify this. This I am writing, amount is equal to R into 1 plus I whole power N minus 1 divided by I into 1 plus I. Just this 1 plus I am writing at the end. Now look at this formula, sir. Look at this formula. This is nothing but amount of an ordinary annuity. This is nothing but amount of an ordinary annuity. So the formula of amount of ordinary annuity, when multiplied with 1 plus I, it is converted into formula for annuity due. So amount for due is equal to amount for ordinary annuity into 1 plus n. Amount of ordinary annuity. Amount of ordinary annuity into 1 plus I. That is the formula for amount D. Okay. Let me explain this point one more time.
Sorry.
A person deposited some amount in a bank in this way. Rupees R is deposited by you or by me in a bank at the beginning of each year. Now, sir, beginning of the first year, R rupees is deposited. Beginning of the second year, again, R rupees is deposited. Beginning of the third year, R rupees is deposited, etc. Beginning of the nth year, R rupees is deposited. R rupees is deposited. Now, the amount is withdrawn at the end of nth year. The amount is withdrawn at the end of the nth year. Now, how can I think this? Look at the last payment I have, R rupees. It is in the bank for 1 year. Last payment of mine is beginning of the nth year. And amount is withdrawn at the end of the nth year. Therefore, this payment is in the bank for 1 year. And you are receiving interest at the rate of I percent. So, this R rupees will become R into 1 plus I at the end of 1 year. Now, the payment preceding to this, that is beginning of the n minus 1th year. It is in the bank for 2 years. So, it will become R into 1 plus I whole square. This way, if I proceed, the first payment is at the beginning of 1st year. The first payment is at the beginning of 1st year. It is in the bank for n years. It is in the bank for n years. So, it is R into 1 plus I whole power n. R into 1 plus I whole power n. This way. Add all these values. R into 1 plus I plus R into 1 plus I whole square plus R into 1 plus I whole cube plus etc. plus R into 1 plus I whole power n. This way it is going on. Now, this series is in geometric progression. This series is in geometric progression. Whose first term is R into 1 plus I and whose common ratio is 1 plus I. Now, there is a formula in geometric progression to find the sum. Sm is equal to A into R to the power of n minus 1 by R minus 1. So, first term is R into 1 plus I. Common ratio is 1 plus I power n minus 1 by R minus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel this formula again. What I am doing? 1 plus I am writing here at the end and the remaining terms at 1 plus I am writing. As and when the formula is readjusted, this first one is nothing but formula for ordinary annuity. R into 1 plus I whole power n minus 1 by I is nothing but formula for ordinary annuity. This is for amount formula. So, amount formula of ordinary annuity when multiplied with 1 plus I. When multiplied with 1 plus I, it will become amount for due. It will become for amount for due. Okay, this way formula is defined. Similarly, I can write the formula for present value also. So, present value of due is equal to present value for due is equal to present value of ordinary annuity into 1 plus I. So, this is equal to R into 1 minus 1 by 1 plus I whole power n. Into 1 plus I. So, this is the formula for present value of due. Okay. Now, let us see some numerical problems on this one. Some numerical problems. Now let us see the first question for amount of due. Look at the question. Find the amount. Question number one. Find the amount at the end of 8 years of an annuity of rupees 300 of rupees 300 payable at the beginning of each year until 8 payments have been made if money is worth 6% compounded annually 6% compounded annually. This is my question. Now I have to concentrate here. Payable at the beginning of each year. Whenever it is specified that the payments are at the beginning of period, then you have to use annuity due concept. What is the size of each payment? Rupees 300. See the solution, sir. R is equal to rupees 300. How many payments are given? N payments are given. Now I is equal to 0.06. Effective rate of interest is 6%. Means 0.06. No conversions are required. Now write the formula for amount for due. This is equal to R by I into 1 plus I into 1 plus I whole power n minus 1. 1 plus I whole power n. Now look at this question. This is 300 divided by 0.06 into 1.06. 1.06 to the power 8 minus 1. So first you have to raise the power of 1.06 to 8. You know how to raise 1.06 into. Then on the left hand side corner you will get a number 1. Press is equal to sign. This till this number will become 9. Here power is to be raised to 8. So press is equal to sign till the left hand side corner number will become 9. Now this is simple fact. From this 1 should be subtracted, minus 1 is equal to, and it is multiplied with 1.06 is equal to into 300 is equal to divided by 0.06 is equal to, it is 3147 rupees 3147.39. This is the amount you are going to receive at the end of 8th year. 1300 rupees is deposited in a bank at the beginning of each year. Okay, this is the first question. Next. Look at one question number two. At the beginning of each period, consisting of 6 months, ₹1500 is deposited into a savings account that pays 5% compounded semi-annually. Find the balance at the end of 5 years. This is my question. Look at the problem, sir. At the beginning of each period, underline this. At the beginning of each period, consisting of 6 months, ₹1500 is deposited into a savings account. Beginning of each period means you have to use the due concept, and your payments are semi-annually. After every 6 months, you are depositing how much? ₹1500. See the solution part of this. R is equal to ₹1500. Nominal rate of interest is 0.05. This 5% is per annum. It is divided by 2 because interest is calculated semi-annually. 0.025. Semi-annually 0.025. N is equal to 5 into 2, 10. How many payments are there? 10 payments are given. So 10 times bank will calculate interest. Amount is equal to 1500 divided by 0.025 into 1.025 into 1.025 whole to the power of 10 minus 1. Formula is amount is equal to R by I into 1 plus I into 1 plus I whole power n minus 1. Just I substituted the values in it. Now once again, 1.025 power is to be raised to 10. 1.025 into power is to be raised to 10. So you have to press is equal to sign till the left hand side corner number will become 11. So value is obtained. From this you have to subtract 1. Minus 1 is equal to into 1.025 is equal to, again it is multiplied with 1500 is equal to, divided by 0.025. This is 17,225. It is ₹17,225.199. You can approximate this to ₹17,225.2. 17,225.2. That is the answer you are. That is the amount you will get at the end of 50 years. Next question. Question number 3. Find the amount of an annuity find the amount of an annuity. Find the amount of an annuity of rupees 2000 payable at the beginning of each month for 3 years. For 3 years at the rate of at the rate of 15% compounded annually at the rate sorry compounded monthly Now look at the solution. Once again, you have to concentrate here at the beginning of each month. How you are depositing, sir? 2000 rupees you are depositing in a bank at the beginning of each month. So size of your payment R is equal to rupees 2000. R is equal to rupees 2000. Per month means N is equal to 36. That is T into 12, 3 years, and per month it is, deposits are at the beginning of each month, so per year 12 payments, in 3 years it is 36 payments. Now I is equal to 0.15 divided by 12. .125 divided by 12 0.0125. This is the interest rate you have to use for calculation. Amount is equal to R by I into 1 plus I into 1 plus I whole power n minus 1. So this is equal to 2000 divided by 0.0125 whole to the power of 36 minus 1. So once again we have to raise the power of 1.1025 to 36. When I press 1.025 into left hand side corner you have a number 1, press is equal to sign till this number will become 37. Whatever this value is, 2.09756. From this you subtract 1 minus 1 into 1.0125 into 2000 is equal to divided by 0.0125 177,805. It is rupees 177,805.9. So you can approximate this to 177,806. It is 947. So approximated to 177,806. Let me check up the calculations one more time, sir. This is 1.0125 into 36. 37, it is 1.56. So my calculations are wrong here. I'll do it once again. Minus 1 is equal to into 1.0125 is equal to multiplied with 2000 is equal to divided by 0.0125. 91,000 it is rupees 91,358.8986. So rupees 91,359 rupees approximate when you want to round it up to the next number, or you can leave it. Okay. This is the answer, 91,359. Okay. See the next question. A bank pays interest at the rate of 12% compounded quarterly find how much should be deposited in the bank at the beginning of each quarter in order to accumulate rupees 10,000 in 4 years. In order to accumulate rupees 10,000 in 4 years, look at the question, sir. A bank pays interest at the rate of 12% compounded quarterly. So nominal rate of interest is 0.12. The rate of interest which is to be used for calculations, is 0.12 divided by 4, 0.03. This is 0.03. Now, how many times bank will give interest? N is equal to T into 4. In 1 year, bank is calculating interest 4 times. Therefore, in 4 years, how many times it will calculate? 4 into 4, this is 60. So, amount is equal to R by I into 1 plus I. 1 plus I whole power n minus 1. So, this is equal to R. We have to calculate, amount is given as 10,000. R by I, I can replace I with 0.03 into 1.03, 1.03 whole to the power of 16 minus 1. 1.03 into power 16. Minus 1 is equal to into 1.03 is equal to, this is simplified, divided by 0.03, this is equal to 20.7615. so 10,000 is equal to 20.7615 into R. So R is equal to 10,000 divided by 20.7615. So this is 10,000 divided by MRC is equal to 481.65 rupees. 481.658. This much we have to deposit at the beginning of each quarter. Then I want to accumulate 10,000 rupees in 4 years. 10,000 rupees in 4 years. Okay. Next question. Find the present value of an annuity due. Find the present value of an annuity due. Find the present value of an annuity due of rupees 700 payable at the beginning of each year. At the beginning of each year, at the beginning of each year for 7 years. For 7 years, if money is worth, if money is worth 7% effective, now this time I want to calculate the present value. See the solution. Present value of due is equal to R by I into 1 plus I, 1 minus 1 by 1 plus I whole power N. This 1 plus I I'll write here 1 plus I into. This is present value of ordinary annuity formula. This is present value of ordinary annuity formula. When it is multiplied with 1 plus I, it will be due formula. It will be due formula. So this is how much deposited 1 plus I. It is 0.07. So let me do it once again. 1.07 to the power 7 into minus 1 is equal to plus minus sign. This is 1.07 into power is raised to 7. So its power is raised to 7. Store it in memory. Memory plus 1 divided by MRC is equal to one should be subtracted from this. You will get a negative value, but I know it is a positive value. So by pressing this plus oblique minus button, minus sign is eliminated. So this is simplified, including 1 multiplied with 700, and this is divided by 0.07, and it is multiplied with 1.07, 4036.57. It is rupees 4036.57. This is the present value of an annuity due. Present value of an annuity due. Okay. Next concept is perpetuity. Perpetuity. Next concept is perpetuity. When equal payments are made, when equal payments are made at the end of equal intervals of time, equal intervals of time forever, then it is called a perpetuity. Then it is called a perpetuity. Second point, for perpetuity we can calculate present value only. Present value only. For perpetuity we can calculate present value only. So present value of ordinary, that is present value of perpetuity, R by I. Present value of perpetuity is equal to R by I, where R is equal to size of the payments. Now when will we use this perpetuity concept, sir? There is a trust which is giving prizes to meritorious students every year. Now the trust will go on forever, and it is an example of perpetuity. So this concept of going forever is a perpetuity. In CA Foundation we have only one question given in the ICA material, but it is more important when you go to intermediate and final. So present value of perpetuity is equal to R by I. Next, when equal payments are made at the beginning of equal intervals of time forever, then it is called perpetuity due. Then it is called perpetuity due. So what is the formula for that? Present value of perpetuity due, R by I into 1 plus I. Ordinary perpetuity multiplied with 1 plus I, it will become formula for due. It will become formula for due. Okay. Look at the question here. If money is worth rupees, if money is worth 6% per annum, find the present value of perpetuity. Find the present value of perpetuity of rupees 330 payable annually. See the solution here. R is equal to rupees 330. I is equal to 0.06. Present value of perpetuity 330 divided by 0.06. 330 divided by 0.06. This is rupees 5500. Okay. Remaining in the next session, sir. Thank you.